Are you blind when you're born?
Can you see in the dark?
Dare you look at a king?
Would you sit on his throne? Can you say of your bite that it's worse than your bark?
Are you cock of the walk
when you're walking alone?
Because jellicles are, and jellicles do, jellicles do, and jellicles would. Jellicles would, and jellicles can, and jellicles do.
When you fall on your head, do you land on your feet?
Are you tense when you sense there's a storm in the air?
Can you find your way blind when you're lost in the street?
Do you know how to go to the heavy side layer?
Because jellicles can, and jellicles do. Jellicles do, and jellicles can. Jellicles can, and jellicles do. Jellicles do, and jellicles can. Jellicles can, and jellicles do.
Can you ride on a broomstick to places far distant? Familiar with candle,
with book and with bell.
Were you Whittington's friend?
The Pied Piper's assistant.
Have you been in alumnus of heaven and hell?
Are you mean like a minx?
Are you mean like a lynx?
Are you keen to be seen when you're smelling a rat?
Were you there when the pharaohs commissioned the sphinx?
If you were and you are, you're a jellicle cat. Jellicle songs for jellicle cats. 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 We can dive through the air like a flying trapeze. We can turn double somersaults, bounce on a tire. We can run up a wall, we can swing through the trees. We can balance on bars, we can walk on a wire.
Surprise
as much as to say, well, now, how about that?
Do I actually see with my own very eyes a man who's not heard of a Jellicle cat? What's a Jellicle cat?
What's a Jellicle cat? Holiday games. You may think at first I'm as mad as a hatter when I tell you a cat must have three different names. First of all, there's the name that the family use daily, such as Peter, Augustus, Alonzo, or James, such as Victor, or Jonathan, George, or Little Bailey. All of them sensible, everyday names. There are fancier names if you think they sound sweeter. Some for the gentlemen, some for the dames, such as Plato, Admetus, Electra, Demeter, but all of them sensible, everyday names. But I tell you, a cat needs a name that's particular, a name that's peculiar, and more dignified. Else how can he keep up his tail perpendicular, or spread out his whiskers, or cherish his pride? Of names of this kind, I can give you a quorum, such as Monkey Strap, Craxer, or Corico Pat, such as Bomb Margarina, or S. Jelly Lorum, names that never belong to more than one cat. But above and beyond, there's still one name left over, and that is the name that you never will guess, the name that no human research can discover, but the cat himself knows and will never confess. When you notice a cat in profound meditation, the reason I tell you is always the same. His mind is engaged in a rapt contemplation of the thought, of the thought, of the thought, of his name, his ineffable, ineffable.
Jellicle cats come out tonight. Jellicle cats come one, come all. The Jellicle moon is shining bright. Jellicles come to the Jellicle ball. Jellicle cats come out tonight. Jellicles come to the Jellicle ball.
Jellicle cats come out tonight. Jellicle cats come one, come all. The Jellicle moon is shining bright. Jellicles come to the Jellicle ball. Jellicle cats come out tonight. Jellicle cats come one, come all.
Jellicle cats meet once a year at the Jellicle ball, where we all rejoice, and the Jellicle leader will soon appear and make what is known as the Jellicle choice. When old Deuteronomy, just before dawn, through a silence you feel you could cut with a knife, announces the cat who can now be reborn and come back to a different Jellicle life. For waiting up there is the Heaviside Lair, with wonders one Jellicle only will see. And Jellicles ask, because Jellicles dare.
Who will it be?
Her name is Jenny Annie Dots. Her coat is of the tabby kind, with tiger stripes and leopard spots. All day she sits beneath the stairs, or on the steps, or on the mat. She sits and sits and sits and sits, and that's what makes a Gumby cat. That's what makes a Gumby cat.
But when the day's hustle and bustle is done, then the Gumby cat's work is but hardly begun. And when all the family's in bed and asleep, she tucks up her skirts to the basement to creep. She is deeply concerned with the ways of the mice.
Their behavior's not good and the manner's not nice.
So when she has got them lined up on the matting, she teaches them
music, crocheting, and tatting.
I have a Gumby cat in mind. Her name is Jenny Annie Dots. The curtain cord she likes to wind and tie it into sailor knots. She sits upon the windowsill or anything that's smooth and flat. She sits and sits and sits and sits, and that's what makes a Gumby cat. That's what makes a Gumby cat.
But when the day's hustle and bustle is done, then the Gumby cat's work is but hardly begun. She thinks that the cockroaches
need employment
to prevent them from
idle and wanton destroyment.
So she's born from that lot of disorderly louts, a troop of a disciplined, helpful Boy Scouts,
with a purpose in life and a good deed to do.
And she's even created a Beatles tattoo.
I'd rather have grouse.
If you put me in a house, I would much prefer a flat. If you put me in a flat, then I'd rather have a house. If you set me on a mouse, then I only want a rat. If you set me on a rat, then I'd rather chase a mouse. Sit it.
And there isn't any need for me to shout it. Doing anything about it.
Burundung-Togger is a terrible bore.
Oh, will you let me in? Then I want to go out. I'm always on the wrong side of every door.
as I'm at home, then I like to get about.
I like to lie in the bureau drawer,
but I make such a fuss if I can't get out.
Dum dum dum, Dogger is a curious cat,
and there isn't any need for you to doubt it.
For he will do as he do,
and there's no doing anything about wow it. My disobliging ways are a matter of a habit.
If you offer me fish, then I always want to feast. When there isn't any fish, then I won't eat rat. If you offer me cream, then I sniff and sniff.
For I only like what I find for myself. No.
So you catch me in it right up to my ears if you put it away on a lot of shelves.
Funny laugh in the middle of your sewing, but there's nothing I enjoy like a horrible
need for me to spout it.
For he will do as he do,
and there's no doing anything about
it.
Suppose that glamour cat. Isabella the glamour cat. Isabella the glamour cat.
Whoever suppose that
not skin and bones. In fact, he's remarkably fat. He doesn't haunt pubs.
He has 8 or 9 clubs.
For he's the St. James's Street cat.
He's the cat we all greet as he walks down the street in his coat of fastidious black.
No commonplace mouses have such well-cut trousers or such an impeccable back.
In the whole of St. James's, the smartest of names is the name of this rabble of cats. And we're all of us proud to be nodded or bowed to by Buster the Jones in White's Fats.
My visits are occasional to the senior educational, and it is against the rules for any one cat to belong both to that and the joint superior schools. When I'm seen in a hurry, there's probably curry at the Siamese or at the Glutton. When I look full of gloom, then I've lunched at the Tomb on cabbage, rice pudding, and mutton.
In the whole of St. James's, the smartest of names is the name of this rabble of cats. And we're all of us proud to be nodded or bowed to by Buster the Jones in White.
In this way passes Buster's first day. At one club or another he's found. It can be no surprise that under our eyes he has grown unmistakably round. He's a 25-pounder,
but I am a bounder,
and he's putting on weight every day.
But I'm so well preserved because I've observed all my life a routine, and I'd say I am still in the prime. I shall last out my time.
That's the word from the stoutest of cats.
It must and it shall be spring.